Today we're going to talk about il congiuntivo. And the first thing to say is that it's not translated as conjunctive in English. There's no such word. It's the subjunctive in English. So what is it? And does it exist in English? Well, the answer may surprise you. Yes, it does. Let's see some examples. The doctor recommended that she drink 8 glasses of water a day. That she drink is a subjunctive, because otherwise you would say she drinks, right? It is important that the instructions be printed in large letters. Be is the subjunctive, because otherwise you would say the instructions are. And also, if I were you, I wouldn't wear that. You know this one, you use it all the time. If I were you, were is the subjunctive. So, let's see when it's used in Italian. Well, in a lot of cases, a lot. First, it's used with impersonal constructions. Some examples of those would be è bene che, è importante che, è necessario che. So it is good that, important that, necessary that, bad that. So anything that starts with it is and then continues with bene che, etc. With expressions of opinion, doubt, or emotion, so anything that is not a straightforward statement of fact, but rather is colored with some kind of personal opinion or uncertainty or emotion. The examples of these expressions are very numerous. For example, penso che, non so se, dubito che, sono felice che. Lots and lots and lots of these examples. And so if you ask me now, so are you saying that every time so far that we use penso che and we said something, we said it wrong? The answer is yes, yes. But I didn't correct you because I knew that we were going to get to it eventually. Also, you may hear that the Italians do not always use the subjunctive when they're supposed to. I encourage you to use it when you learn how to use it correctly, because it's a mark of an educated person. In indirect commands, I will use the subjunctive in Italian. For example, if I say voglio che, desidero che, ordino che, so I want that someone else do something. That's an indirect command, and I will want to use the subjunctive. And lastly, with certain conjunctions, these are coming up later on. All of these things are actually called subjunctive triggers, but in particular these conjunctions that you probably are not familiar with because we haven't studied them yet. We avoided them like a plague precisely because we knew that they require subjunctive, and so we tried not to use them. For example, magari, if only, senza che, without, affinché, so that, sebbene, even though, although, a patto che, provided that, and numerous, numerous others. When I first started learning the subjunctive in Italian, I actually wrote out a bunch of charts, and I wrote all these expressions down so that I, at a glance, could tell whether the expression requires the use of the subjunctive or not. So, let's see some examples. Do use the subjunctive when? Before the examples, actually, these are some fast rules. 3 conditions are necessary in order for you to use the subjunctive. The first one is you have to have 2 clauses, the main clause and the subordinate clause. I hope you remember your grade school grammar. Clauses are like little sentences within a larger sentence, and each clause has to have a separate verb. Note that the main clause must contain one of the subjunctive triggers, so an expression of doubt or uncertainty or emotion or impersonal expression, any of those things. You have to have a connector between the 2 clauses. In Italian, it should be che or se, that or if. And lastly, you have to have 2 different subjects. So each of those 2 clauses has to have a different subject. Now let's see some examples. Do use the subjunctive when you have a sentence like this. Lo psicologo suggerisce che tu debba dormire di più. Let's see. If we have those 3 conditions, do we have 2 clauses, 2 verbs? We have suggerisce, and then we have debba. So we do have 2 clauses. Do we have a connector? Yeah, we do. Do we have 2 different subjects? In the first one, the subject is lo psicologo. In the second one, tu. So we do have 2 different subjects. So this is a correct use of the subjunctive. È importante che il dirigente sia molto in gamba. Do we have 2 different clauses? Do we have 2 different verbs? E is one, and then sia is another verb. So, yes, we do have 2 different clauses. È importante, and then il dirigente sia molto in gamba. Okay. Do we have the connector? Yep, we do. Do we have two different subjects? The first clause is è importante, meaning it is important. So it is an impersonal subject, but it's a subject nonetheless. The subject is it. And in the second clause, the subject is il dirigente. And so those three conditions have been met. I can use the subjunctive. Non so se i lavoratori abbiano capito la situazione. Do we have two clauses? I have non so, so is one verb. I lavoratori abbiano capito, two different verbs, two clauses. Yep. Do I have a connector? Yes. This time I have a connector se, if. Do I have two different subjects? In the first clause, the subject is io non so, non so. In the second one, i lavoratori, I do have two different subjects. All the conditions have been met, and I can use the subjunctive. Let's see when not to use the subjunctive. I'll give you a sentence, you try to figure out what's wrong with it. Sono sicura che tu sia una persona responsabile. Here I do have two clauses, I do have the connector, I do have two subjects. Sono sicura is io, I, tu sia is tu, but this is still not correct. Can you figure out why? Why I should use just the indicative mood of the verb essere, che tu sei, because in the first clause, sono sicura, that's not a subjunctive trigger because I'm expressing certainty. Remember, I have to express uncertainty or uncertainty, I think, uncertainty or doubt or emotion in order to be able to use the subjunctive. Let's see another example. Lui è triste che lui debba partire domani. I have two clauses. Yeah, I do. I have the connector. However, che lui debba is still not correct. Do you know why? Because I do not have two different subjects. The subject of the first clause is lui, and he is also the subject of the second clause. And so I will not use che lui debba. Instead, I will use di with the infinitive. Lui è triste di dover partire domani. Dover is just dovere, but when I have another verb in the infinitive following, then I'll just truncate that first verb and drop the final e, but it's just dovere. And so, when the subject is the same, even if the first clause is normally a subjunctive trigger, because I don't have two subjects, I will not use the subjunctive. Instead, I will use di with the infinitive of the verb. So, these are some of the general rules as to why or when I should use the subjunctive, because the pitfall of these things, when I start learning a new form, a new verb mood, I tend to overuse it. So these are some of the general rules that explain when you should use the subjunctive. If you have any questions, please email me.